everybody, and welcome to another edition of VA Online Radio. Sorry, I haven't been around for a while. I've been working on my website and working with some people that I have living with me here, trying to get some things done for 2010, because it looks to be a big year. Looks like I have Lincoln on the line. Is that you, Lincoln?
Yes, I'm here. Hello, Tamid.
Hey. How are you doing?
Good, good. I'm doing well. How are you doing out in California?
Well, I mean, we're doing well out here. I mean, it's a crazy circumstance, but I try to, you know, keep 100% in my mind all the time. It's just a dream world, you know, a figment of the imagination.
Yeah, yeah, California can get pretty intense with the all the speed at which everyone moves and everyone speaks and all the activity happens.
Yeah, definitely, especially in the Bay Area, that area down there, where I'm from. People are moving a million miles an hour, you know. It's so crazy. Yeah, you're absolutely right. So, when I was talking to you about hosting the show, it seemed that you were getting some kind of similar intuition or some kind of similar feelings about that 2010 was going to be, a monumental year.
Mm-hmm. Yes. In my own life, and based on the intuition that I have, it seems that there's a lot of energy coming in right now to accelerate people on their own path of personal growth. It seems like there's a push happening from the universe to bring people more into their path based upon what they're intending to create. So if a person,
they're gonna help a choice to happen.
What was that?
I said that to kind of set up the circumstances to make it make people more not make people, but make the choices more visible so that people could take them.
Yes, yeah. When there's an accelerated energy coming into our lives, it brings everything that we're intending, everything that we're thinking, into a clearer experience. So it will be more easy for us to recognize the choices and the decisions we're making and the effects they're having on our lives. Basically, the energy it empowers what we're seeing. It empowers our ability as creators. So when this energy becomes more dominant in the earth, as it has been increasing lately, it's more easy to see who we are as creators. And I believe this is leading up into the greater experience of earth changes and the greater acceleration of human evolution that is proposed to happen in the year 2012.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah. I mean, I was listening to something from Bashar, who's somebody that I trust, one of the channels that I trust. Are you familiar with Bashar?
Yeah, I've heard of him, and I've only seen a few minutes of maybe like 3 or 4 minutes of one of his teachings. I'm not real big into doing any type of spiritual research anymore. Like I don't read books. I don't my learning days are over. I have established the connection within myself, so I pretty much just live life and experience the wonder and the joy of it all.
Either way, something he said was that in 2012, what we're going to see is, the reason I mentioned is because something that strikes me in my intuition is as being true, that in 2012, we would see interactions on a global scale move over 50% positive in all countries and in all areas, that things would be, that would be like the crossing of the event horizon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's wonderful.
But, I was going to say that's, it's one possibility.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what I see happening is we're given an opportunity for expedited learning. So we become more aware of the choices we're making, and we see them more clearly made manifest in our lives. And as people wake up to this, it becomes really clear what we have to do. Now, keep in mind that everybody has an internal guidance system. It's intuition. It's even when you open up your higher spiritual abilities, you can communicate with or through this higher intelligence within us.
and inner guru that Sri Ramana talks about?
Yes, yes. And it's always guiding us because it's in alignment with a higher intelligence, a universal intelligence, and some call it, you know, a higher plan or the will of God, the plan of God. But really, it's a universal intelligence rather than a being called God that's telling us what to do. It's the natural order of everything. And when we make choices and decisions, we can feel within us or we can dialogue within us to see if these choices and decisions were in fact with our highest good and within the highest good of all life. And even as a child, everyone has this internal guide within them, or a moral compass. You know, we know when we hurt someone else. We know when we benefit someone else. We can feel it. And so with this new energy, the voice within us is getting louder, which is encouraging us to listen to ourselves more, to listen to our inner guidance, and to live a life that's in harmony with everyone and everything else. So it's going to be more difficult to stay asleep, more difficult to ignore this greater intelligence that's within each and every person. And I believe that's possibly what Bashar is talking about, is that everyone is becoming more in alignment with themselves. And as you become more in alignment, you do things that are naturally uplifting for everyone and that naturally benefit all life. And it'd be amazing to see us tip the scale and to see, you know, greed and war and ideas of separation and all of these behaviors and beliefs just start to dissolve as everyone realizes the unity that that exists within all life everywhere. So that
really is the beginning and the end of the enlightenment.
Mm-hmm.
The resolution of duality and the unity out of perceived separation. I mean, still like two years later after I began having satsang and, you know, trying to reach out to people, and I think that the only thing that ever gives anybody the qualifications to reach out to somebody is just a simple perception of selfhood. And either way, since the beginning, you know, this question of separation, it still remains as the number one question.
Yeah, there's a lot of confusion around the idea of unity consciousness and separation and oneness, and I think a lot of it comes because when we hear things like enlightenment, or we hear things of oneness, we believe that we don't have it. We believe that it's something separate and distant, and therefore it takes on an aura of mystery, and there's some inner confusion. But the more we research, the more we understand that unity is our natural state, and that it's all of our beliefs about being separate that is keeping us from realizing what already is. Enlightenment is not something grand. It's not something special. It's just being yourself in a more pure, refined way. Because there's, you know, 7 billion people on this planet, and the majority of them are living an idea of who they think they are. They're believing and acting from a place of a personality with social beliefs based upon their culture, based upon their family, beliefs based upon their childhood experience. And so we live based upon these ideas, and we react to the world from these ideas. They've created a solidified sense of self in our subconscious, and so we find ourselves reacting to the world to defend our belief about who we are and what the world is. And the trickiness of the ego is that the ego has associated emotion and energy with the thought process. And so when we think thoughts, we feel the power of the emotion, and then we say, well, how can these thoughts not be real? How can these thoughts not be the truth of what is? Because there's such a powerful response in the emotional body. But the reality is that the emotions can be controlled and are controlled by ourself as a conscious being, and our thoughts are controlled by ourself as a conscious being. Because the more we wake up into awareness, the more we see that these are just aspects of our creation. They're an aspect of our created self within this world. So when we foster an ability to look at this and to be more aware of